I barely hear it. Episode P4. Experience the story of Persona 4. Is there really good? Okay, here we go. Oops. Persona 4. Why is this so fucking... This is the first game that's not... Kitty cat. Who's a fluffy kitty cat? We already played Persona 4 twice. Hi, Andy. We'll go in order, I guess. Also, I think the resolution's a little off. There we go. Well, and then slightly over more. That looks about it. Yeah. Well, still can't hear it. Oh, Max. Maybe it's a good thing you don't hear it, so I don't have any copyright strikes for the music. Or claims.
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
Hi, Igor. It's been a while.
Ah, it seems we have a guest with an intriguing destiny. My name is Igor. I am delighted to make your acquaintance.
Nose.
This place exists between dream and reality, mind and matter. It is a room that only those
the
who
company
are bound
line.
By contract may enter. It may be that such a fate awaits you in the near future. Now then, why don't you introduce yourself?
You don't recognize me? Doesn't even get a chance to like fuck up a name. Oh god, white light. I don't like this. Yes, it is blinding. I'm glad we can agree on something.
I was on my way back.
Ace voice acted it. Like the dancing game. How are you, Andy? When is your next concert thing?
What everyone's been up to.
I don't know, let's find out. Starbucks, that's not Dunkin' Donuts or Pete's.
Damn it! I still haven't picked up Yosuke's gift.
Only Yosuke's?
Hello? Is this Sensei?
Hi, Teddy.
Sorry to bring this up, but I forgot to tell you something very important. I have a special request for the souvenirs I'm sure you'll be bringing your bear's friend. Oh, and one more thing. Can I ask you to pick up something for Yosuke too?
I was planning on bringing something for everyone anyway, but go ahead.
Cool! Well, Yosuke's been down in the dumps after his mommy burned his favorite nurse.
Wait, what? Am I reading the sentence correct? Been down in the dumps after his mommy burnt his favorite nurse? What?
She was what I called scorching hot. Just kidding.
A nurse?
Yeah, I'm...
Come on, Sensei. You know what I'm talking about. about?
No, I don't.
His nurse magazine with the chest examinations and the...
Oh, his smuts. Gotcha.
I see. And you expect me to buy him a replacement?
Of course, silly. People coming to visit are supposed to bring presents.
I am not buying Asuka smuts.
Mm-hmm. All right.
No, don't agree to that.
I was planning to head back tomorrow, but since we're meeting up early, I decided to go back today. Can you pass that on to everyone?
Aha! Then the sexy nurses will be arriving even sooner.
Oh, God damn it, Teddy.
It'll be like, Sensei, we have an emergency.
Please stop, Teddy!
Okay, then. We'll be waiting for you!
Nurses, huh?
Now pulling into Yaso Inaba. This will be the last stop. Yaso Inaba.
Oh.
Can't wait until tomorrow. Okay, we're gonna be sitting here for a while for cutscenes to happen, I guess.
Now, what should I do? Nanako?
Big bro!
Nanako.
You came to meet me all on your own?
Gave me money for the bus. He said he couldn't make it, so I came instead. Welcome back, big bro. I wanted to see you so much.
Thanks. to see you again, too.
That either a new voice actor or the voice actor's voice... I don't know. Sounds slightly off. I'm not reading all this.
Well, no sense standing around here. What's in the fridge at home?
Lots! Dad and I bought a ton of stuff since you were coming to visit. Are you gonna cook dinner? Ooh, I wanna help!
Good evening. This is the Evening Journal with news for May 2nd. Our top story is on the domestic airline that was hijacked yesterday.
It's raining.
God.
That brings back some memories. Nothing will show anymore, though.
Damn it. I don't have a temperature. I feel warm, though.
Just in case.
I mean, theoretically, you should still have the ability to go through the TV.
Rivals! They are friends! Yet powerful foes! The desperate fighting program amongst high school students! A new legend is about to start!
May the manliest of all men come on down!
Nobody touches his precious Nanako! The sister complex kingpin of steel, Yu Narukami!
It's only natural.
Wage slave in the boonies by day, hero by night, Captain Ressentiment, Yosuke Hanamura!
Everything that bores me has gotta go!
A spunky dragon with deadly legs, the carnivore whose discarded womanhood, Shie Satunaka!
You need to eat more meat!
Please escort me to the ring, my prince! The unconquerable snow black, Yukiko Amagi!
I'll finish you in one strike!
Blooming roses and bulging muscles, the blood-curdling beefcake emperor, Kanji Tatsumi!
Deep into realms of romance!
The body of a child, the brain of a genius, the 2000 IQ killjoy detective, Naoto Shirogane!
Is this an army of idiots?
Fight and survive towards the one throne waiting at the end! The P1 Grand Prix, where fierce fights will be fought! The battle begins tonight!
That's everything about that.
What?
What on earth was that?
What? Sister Complex Kingpin of Steel. Let's see, H. Hanamura Yosuke.
Hello, this is Yosuke.
Yosuke?
It's nothing. I just freaked out when you called all of a sudden. Yeah, that's it. What's up? Hey, when do you want to meet?
That's not why I was calling. I saw the Midnight Channel. You saw it too, right?
Huh?
Did Teddy not tell you? Since we're meeting up early tomorrow, I decided to come today. I figured you wouldn't think I could have seen it, so I gave you a call.
I assumed you weren't here yet, so I didn't want to rely on you.
You haven't changed. So how about it? You're not gonna leave this be, are you, Captain Ressentiment?
Why'd you zero in on that part? Did you see how they called you a sister complex kingpin?
Mine's not that bad.
You think? Oh, I ought to tell you, that program's not the only strange thing lately. Teddy, Rise, and Kanji aren't here either. They disappeared.
Of course they did. And you're now just telling me this?
Alright, we should get together tomorrow like we planned.
Yeah, at the Jeunesse food court. Welcome back, partner.
It's good to be here. Oh, right. Sorry to say, I forgot to pick up your souvenir.
A souvenir? Don't even worry about it, man.
You sure? I thought you were really looking forward to it. Those nurses.
Nurses?
Yeah, Teddy asked me to get it for you. He said you were crushed that they got burned.
Oh, wait, this is all...
I didn't know you were into nurses.
Shut up! That's enough! Damn it, you're trying to wind me up, aren't you? Stay home, you jerk.
But I'm already here. Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Well, I guess that's the reason why Teddy couldn't tell them.
Good to see you guys again.
Welcome back! We missed you! The guest of honor's finally here! You're looking well.
Welcome back. Should we...
Huh? Oh, he already knows about the Midnight Channel thing. He's actually the one who called me up about it.
Oh, I see. This has turned into a pretty thrown-together reunion, hasn't it? But I'm glad you came.
It sucks that we can't hang out more before jumping into another mystery, but to celebrate our partner's return, I hereby reinstate the investigation team in response to the Midnight Channel going back on the air last night.
Oh, the team is back! Just hearing that name again gets me all fired up. Yeah, let's do this!
Yeah, let's hopefully prevent another murder. Woo!
I don't think the applause is necessary.
Two months. Okay, I'm trying to put to the time frame. So, Persona 4, then this game, then the dancing game?
Well, let's get cracking. I mean, this is no laughing matter. No one's heard from Teddy, Kanji, or Rise. Just those three, right?
Where's,
Yeah. Oh, I got a hold of Naoto, but I didn't tell her about this stuff. She told me she couldn't make it today because of her job, so I didn't want to worry her. She seemed pretty bummed that she couldn't be here, too.
One thing's been bothering me. The picture on the TV was very clear last night.
Yeah. Going by the pattern from last year, it wouldn't be that clear until after the victim entered the TV.
Hey,
first time a big group of people was shown together. Plus, we're still here. Why us anyway? And what's up with those insulting descriptions?
What bothers me most is Teddy. He was acting like the host of that show.
Yeah, and we can't find him.
This smells fishy. Then again, I doubt he would play a prank like this for no reason.
I guess we'll just have to go inside the TV and find out what's going on.
Won't we be stuck in there without Teddy to give us an exit?
Uh-huh, not so. I've had Teddy keep the exit TV out on that side.
Look at you, all prepared.
I mean, think about it. What if we were half asleep and fell into a TV when Teddy wasn't over there? Isn't that a scary thought?
Like anyone would be that clumsy.
Do you have a TV on the fucking floor?
Anyway, it sounds like it's safe for us to go investigate then.
Do you literally have a flat screen TV right beside your bed on the floor? So when you roll out of bed, you just fall right in. I mean, if you do, damn. I wish I had a floor TV.
Yeah, there's no doubt that something's going on in there. Is everyone ready?
We're all good to go. To tell the truth, I had a hunch that this was going to happen.
Why?
It's a holiday, so the store's full of people.
Feel like things are picking up around town.
It's time to go.
Hello. All the models are on sale right now.
You know, it's been a while since last time. I'm a little nervous.
What, 2 months? That's not a long time.
Whoa, wait! There are still people in this aisle!
Hey, get ready! Huh? The customers are going away!
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Let's go!
Yeah!
Isn't this different from usual?
Oh no! What do we do?
What can we do? We can't stop now!
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
Huh? It's not a dream this time? What's going on? Didn't my contract end already?
This room is tied to your fate. Nothing that occurs here is meaningless. Though you reached an end to one journey, you now find yourself here again. This shows that you will once again be faced with a question.
A question? And something really is going on?
From here on, what befalls you will upset your status quo. It is true that you've opened the door once already, but all things change. nothing ever remains the same. What you gained before will change over time as well. You will have to face them once again.
Face them? Again?
Show me how you will proceed down the path that awaits beyond the door you've opened.
Music.
Where am I? This is... No, wait. This has to be the TV world. This has never happened before.
Hello! Sorry for the wait! Greetings, boys and girls of Yasogami! The P1 Grand Prix is about to begin! There's no need for manners or courtesy or anything today, so let it all hang out! Tell us how you really feel!
What the...
But first, the General has a few words for you all.
You're all here now. Well then, I'm proud to announce the opening of our very own P1 Grand Prix!
Teddy, what's going on here? We came to look for you and Risei and...
Ah, always with the talking, Sensei. It's a big waste of time. Less talk and more fighting! With the next challenger, come on down!
They're expecting you and me to fight.
Looks like. Sheesh, what's Teddy thinking?
Starting that up already? I won't let you get all buddy-buddy with each other. These battles are fought to the death. Only the victor can proceed.
This joke's gone on far enough, Teddy. We're not gonna play along with that.
Oh, really? I guess he should declare me the winner then.
Yosuke?
What? You don't plan on fighting, right? That means I win by default. but is that okay with you? I mean, since Nanako-chan's here and all?
Nanako's here?
Wait, really? You haven't seen her? She's with Teddy.
Maybe you can.
Where is she? Yosuke, where's Nanako?
Whoa, what's gotten into you, partner? No need to get hysterical.
Why are you so calm about this? You know what happened to her last time she came here. Yosuke, be straight with me. Are you sure Nanako is with Teddy?
How should I know? If I had to guess, I'd say she's probably still with him. Man, are you all right? Are you that worried about Nanako-chan? It's no wonder people look at you funny, thinking you have a sister complex.
Okay, time to beat him down.
Yosuke, are you all right?
Huh? What are you talking about? I should be the one saying that to you. She's not even your real sister. All that big bro stuff really creeps me out. It was a while ago that I saw her. It's probably too late to save her now. You know how things went last year, after all.
Yosuke.
Time to beat the shit out of him.
Draw your weapon. You'll get your fight.
What? Dude, what are you saying? You told me you let me win by default.
Oh, see how long this takes me to do. Not particularly good at fighting games.
I don't know if you're being controlled or if there's something else going on here. Either way, you must understand the best way to resolve the situation. Sorry, but I'm gonna go all out. No hard feelings.
Huh? All that talk and you're gonna fight against your partner after all? Well, whatever. Let's hurry up and get this started.
Oh, what I did?
Amazing, Sensei! Keep that up and zoom on ahead!
Ahead? You're gonna continue with this? Teddy, about Nanako.
I don't want to spoil the surprise. If you want to find out, you'll have to get to me! And I can't say why, but I think you should hurry.
Thank you.
Yosuke, are you alright?
Ow, couldn't you hold back a little? I seriously thought you were gonna kill me.
The same went for you. I wouldn't have stood a chance if I held back on you.
Anyway, that aside, shut up about the nurses already. It's not like that's the only thing I ever think about.
What's this about nurses?
Huh? You were harping on it the whole time. How can you stand there and constantly bash my taste in women with a straight face?
The fuck?
Is it such a crime to like nurses?
Wait a second. Yosuke, let me ask you something. Is it true that Nanako is here in this world?
She is?
There's no choice but to keep going.
Taking off?
Yeah.
Well, be careful.
Why aren't you just going together? No.
Thing about those nurses.
Ah, quit it already! Are you out of your mind again?
Huh. So there's an invisible wall. Looks like the loser can't leave the room. I see how it works now. Thanks.
Don't use me as your guinea pig. Wait, that's it? Hey, don't wear yourself out, all right?
Welcome to the Velvet Room. Things have only just begun, and yet you already seem tired. The misfortune that has befallen you can be thought of as a sort of trial.
A trial?
Ouchie.
Indeed. I am an observer on your journey. I would do nothing so thoughtless as to force you to make choices. You do not need such provocations. I already know that you shine brilliantly enough. Yes, that is part of your brilliance.
And she read minds, too.
These are masks of resolution, strengthened by controlling one's heart, by forming bonds. You understand this well, don't you?
Yeah, that's how we all fought up till now.
Yes, indeed. But one's heart is intangible. It cannot be seen and cannot be felt. When polished, it releases a strong light unlike anything else. But it can also be clouded by trivial things. Have you ever felt that way? You may be more conscious of that fact than most, because you hold the power of the wild card. From here on, you will be forced to re-examine the things you know as bonds. How will you face the changes to come, and what choices will you make?
Changes, huh?
Oh, fuck.
It might be the announcement room. I feel like I'm being led somewhere.
Someone's eye out swinging that thing around.
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
Sorry ain't gonna cut it. What were you gonna do if you hurt one of the students here, huh? You can't go pulling that stuff without student council approval. All right, the jig is up. I'm putting the kibosh on this tournament right now.
Hey, wait, hold on a second. I'm not in this because I wanna be. I'm trying to stop the tournament. Why are you here, by the way? Wait, did you fall inside a TV?
Fall inside a TV?
Fall inside a TV? What kind of nonsense is that?
I'm Yu Narukami. I was a second year at Yasugami High until last year.
Huh? Last year? But that uniform.
Oh no, this is kind of my usual equipment when I'm in the TV world.
Equipment?
Never mind. Forget it.
Well, if you were only around till last year, I ain't gonna blame you for not knowing. I'm the new student council president. Nice meeting you. it's your turn to spill. You said you ain't in the tournament because you want to be. Then what are you doing here? And what's this tournament about in the first place? So if I got this right, you didn't start this, but your friend did. Well, you don't seem like you're lying.
I'm so tired. Noise.
Hey, that sounded like it came from the gym. I ought to tell you to go home, but I get that you're worried about your sis. Come on, let's go check it out. What is this? Who'd go to all this trouble?
Oh, are you on a hot date, Sensei? Well, that's fine with me, of course. But shouldn't you keep your mind on the fighting? Whoa, you look so mortified! That's the face I was hoping to see!
Hey, you! You're the ringleader of this mess, aren't you? What's the idea, raising a ruckus like this without running it by the student council? Pack it in and clean all this up already.
Oh, fuck.
Should be muzzled and sit in the corner. Sit, puppy. Sit.
I'll take it from here. It's all right. There's nothing to worry about. That was pretty harsh, Teddy. Hard to believe a womanizer like you would say such things.
What's so attractive about a shameless liar like her?
Liar? Do you know something about her?
Come on, Sensei. Your opponent's getting tired of waiting for you. With the next challenger, come on down!
Oh no! Yuko. Yukiko.
It's nothing. Are you alright? Has anything odd happened to you?
Odd? No, I don't think so.
Hanako might be in here. I'm heading to the announcement room where Teddy is. I need you to protect this girl for me. She might be a victim of all this.
Why do I have to do that? It's not like I know her or anything.
Kiko, not you too. Calm down and listen to me. Can you understand what I'm saying?
Huh? What are you saying all of a sudden? I can hear you clearly. What did you mean by you too?
This is probably a trick the enemy is playing on us. They're trying to get us to fight each other. I'll say it one more time, Yukiko. I'd like you to protect this girl for me.
Sorry, but, I don't know how to put this. It just feels like you're being really selfish. You always help people who have nothing to do with you, and I admire that. But where does that leave us? It's always your friends who get put in danger because of your self-centeredness.
Kiko.
What the? Yuka?
Ooh, now that's our senpai. You'll show no mercy, not even to a girl if it's for your own goals. You're a real bastard with a sister complex. Keep it up and bring them all down.
Sorry, but you need to stay back. Whatever you see here, try to stay calm. Promise me you won't run away. Persona!
Come, Konohana Sakuya.
These cocky, self-righteous friends showing how they really feel by being... crap out of each other. That's the real thrill of the P1 Grand Prix!
Are you gonna push this? Why are you doing it anyway? These guys are friends. What's so much fun about making friends fight each other?
It's all right. Thanks, though.
It's not all right! This is...
Sorry, but you're not getting your wish.
What?
Did you think this would be all it took to break us apart? That it would make us hate each other? Sorry to say, but that's a huge mistake on your part. I believe in my friends. They'll never get taken in like that.
You're so stupid! What kind of sensei are you?
I'm warning you now. If you really are Teddy, then we'll get you back to normal no matter what it takes. Even if it costs us our lives. But if you're an imposter, hiding behind Teddy's face, I will make you pay for toying with us.
That girl's come around.
Yukiko, are you all right? I'm sorry I couldn't go easy on you.
No, it's okay. You weren't your usual self, but I could tell by your eyes that there was something going on. I'm sorry, too. Did I hurt you?
Kinda, yeah. I sure wouldn't want to get into it with you again. Hey, did I say things that offended you earlier?
Yes. You did.
I don't need to know what I said. I just wanted to see if my guess was right. It looks like our enemy has the power to confuse our senses. My first opponent was Yosuke, and he told me a similar story after we fought.
Huh? You said something bad to Yosuke-kun too? What did you tell him?
You sure you want to know?
What kind of people are you?
Oh, right. We used our personas.
Yeah, we should at least explain to her what's going on.
Oh boy. Hey, Andy. If you're still there. Can we postpone Stardew Valley until tomorrow? Okay. I'm probably gonna go to bed after ending the stream tonight at 10.
And that's it in a nutshell.
Because I need to wake up early for work. Also, if we play tomorrow, can we start, like, let's say around, like, this time tomorrow?
So, that's what you meant.
If that's possible, with Kyle's schedule.
Yeah, which makes me believe this school could be a part of your mind that's materialized.
This school came from me? That's a lot to swallow. I'm not surprised. Why is it different this time around, though? Usually the victim's shadow appears first.
Okie dokie. Oh, so, talked to my manager yesterday, and I tried to get, like, hours, like, later, like, 9, 10 in the morning. She's not going for it, which is really pissing me off. I'm trying to explain to her that I got a ride to work, and this has to be later in the day, and she's not getting it, or she doesn't want to get it, and it's luckily, I have a coworker pick me up tomorrow, and then I'm seeing if a coworker can pick me up on Sunday, and hopefully I have Monday off so I can get cash for at least a taxi for the rest of the week.
The Teddy who's hosting this tournament, what if he's actually this girl's shadow?
Huh?
I noticed he got agitated when I called him an imposter. A fake Teddy would mean he's someone else using Teddy's form.
I see. If this place reflects Miss President's heart, her shadow must be here.
It would be just easier if I can just walk to work, but no, I got enough, like, enough people gave me shit for walking to work, so. Yeah, I probably should. Or I should just, I don't know, I'm gonna give this next week a chance. But if next week is a fucking shit show, I'm gonna see if I can get moved to Milford's door. Or, you know, closer store. Which might happen or might not happen. I have a strong, it's a strong possibility of that happening because the, whatchamacallit, the store owners works there, and she likes me, and she wants me to work there beforehand, so. I like the people who I work with.
I'm gonna check out the announcement room. That General Teddy's behind the whole shebang, right? And if he came from me, then I gotta own up to the responsibility. A student body president, I can't let this go.
Wait, you're being reckless. We'll take care of the shadow. You need to...
out of this TV world? And how am I supposed to do that? Go on. Show me the door.
Well.
Well, I'm gonna hit the Milford store equally as much. But I guess that one's more convenient. I don't know.
Your little cousin's in the announcement room. And you're gonna go save her, right?
Also, my dad has to be in an IV, on an IV for 6 weeks.
I might not be as strong as the two of you, but I'm no slouch in a fight. Wouldn't it be better if we went together?
No, don't you understand? This world is...
I know it's dangerous, but there's gotta be something only I can do to help. Hell, that aside, I can't leave after causing so much trouble. Making friends fight each other. I'm going on ahead. You don't want to waste time arguing, yeah?
Yep, so I'm going to be alone in this house for at least 6 more weeks. Which gets me a little worried about my cat. Okay, so he's also getting transferred to the same place that my mom's in. And I'm gonna be bringing him the, bills to make up and checkbook and stuff so he can make up the shit.
Please, you have to go after her.
Yeah, and luckily his retirement went through, so he has a large sum of cash in his in their bank account. So the bills shouldn't be much of a problem, even though I already paid 2 of them out of my own money. It's just the only problem I have is leaving my cat alone for most of the day while I'm at work and actually getting to work or to and from work. I need to get a new driver's manual, by the way. So yeah, I found the old one, but I've been told I should get a new one. Since there'll probably be new rules and shenanigans. I don't know. Now I notice the cat's kind of limping. I'm like, oh, great.
Mm-hmm. I believe in you.
I'm hoping it's nothing serious. So I need to keep an eye on that. Right now he's curled up in a ball in my basket on top of my clean clothes, which are not clean anymore since he's sleeping on top of them. But yeah, I need to wake up at 4:30 tomorrow to make sure I have a ride and that I'm up. Although, I won't be mad at you if you wake me up at 3:00 again tomorrow. I actually prefer it. Just letting you know, Ollie. Woke me up at 3:00 this morning. Okie dokie. Thank you. I need to start looking it over. I guess it's time to actually learn how to drive. Still reluctant, but, you know, I'm gonna My hand's kind of getting forced to do this. Oh, that's the velvet room again. Yep.
You seem flustered, but time has no meaning here.
Yeah, I'm just gonna. I think I'm gonna take weekends off from streaming now. Actually, I was kind of reluctant to streaming tonight, but I was like, eh. If I started at 8, I can do a 2-hour stream. It'll be fine.
It seems you've emerged victorious and have come away with a piece of the truth.
And I really wanted to play this game.
Though you are in a garden of deceit, you have the vision to go forward. Very impressive.
Is that student council president's shadow really the cause of all this, then?
Who can say? All I know is that you are getting ever closer to the truth. There is one thing I can tell you. If that girl's shadow is the cause of this misfortune, she will face her trial. But it's separate from your fate. You have your own trial to overcome. Keep that to heart.
My own trial?
Everyone sees various things in you that draw them to you. Salvation, hope. I myself find fascination in watching over you. Fate may not be the author of your trials, but you are destined to be tested.
I'm so tired. You're not gonna be back anytime soon, are you? Oh, you work during the day too. Damn it. I need to find someone to take me to port. I need to pay my tax lady. And give her my parents' information. Ouch, son of a... Yeah, that's kind of a while. That's 2 weeks. And then next we're gonna run into... Chie.
Wait! It's too dangerous to go alone.
Color me impressed that you managed to catch up to me so quick.
Promise me that you won't leave my side, and you can't do anything rash. If you can't agree to those terms, I'll have to force you into protective custody. This is a matter of life and death for you.
Sure thing. Then let's get to that announcement room together.
I like her accent. Sounds southern?
Ask you something.
What is it?
being forced to fight your friends, huh? Sorry. You don't gotta answer.
No, you're right. If I could avoid it, I would. But I believe in my friends.
You mean your friends won't hate you after the fight? Or you think they'll understand that you don't really want to fight?
I don't know. Both, maybe. I mean, there's no way we'd fight each other without some kind of reason.
What if you had to kill each other? Sorry, that was probably over the line. I don't know why I said that.
I wouldn't let it happen.
Doing?
There's an invisible wall. I don't think I can go through here.
An invisible wall? Oh, that must have been why you broke out of the mime act every now and then. Well, if I can pass through, it must only be blocking the tournament fighters. This world sure is out there.
Be careful. This probably means.
Is your snout okay, Sensei? Jeez, you're such a klutz!
You're still using that form? It's getting old. Why don't you just show your true self?
Boy, you've gotten peevish! I don't have any idea what you're talking about!
Okay, so who's my next opponent?
Ooh, now you're getting into the spirit of things. Let me guess, you're starting to enjoy beating up your friends? Okay, with the next challenger, come on down.
Oh, so I'm guessing Kyle's in the office then. Hey, I.
That's what I thought. You're the last of us, after all.
Yeah, I had a feeling you'd be next, too.
Chie, you know what they're doing, right?
Yeah, I know. The stuff we say gets twisted around so we end up fighting each other, right? Don't worry. You're the son of a bitch who left us as soon as the last case ended, but you're still our good friend.
I like that one. He is not here yet, no.
I mean, you have it easy.
You're just fighting your friends. I had to keep killing over and over, all because of you humans!
Excuse me? Carnivore.
More stuff about killing, huh? Miss President was talking about it earlier, too. This must be.
Ah! My elbow!
It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. It hurts. I'll give you a taste of the pain they put me through!
Let's do this, Chet.
Well, well, round three of the P1 Grand Prix already. Word on the street is that the carnivore may have a slight advantage. Will you, Senpai, all talk and no skill, manage to eke out a win this time? Let's get this show on the road.
Look off your face. This isn't fun at all.
I think so. Man, you're strong. I'm kind of shocked at how much of a difference there is between us. So the others are safe too? Oh, what a relief.
You guys really are tight, aren't you? Makes me jealous.
Well, we did spend a whole lot of time together last year because of that case. Sure, I was surprised to hear such weird stuff coming from him, but I know he'd never say any of that to me.
Wait a sec. Who are you? Huh? The student council president? You mean ours? That doesn't seem right. I remember the new president being a guy.
What are you saying? I'm the student council president. Who else would I be?
I'm pretty sure, though. Maybe if you told me your name, I'd remember.
My name? I...
What's wrong?
My... memories. No, I don't want to fight anymore. Why do we have to kill one another?
What?
No way. Wow. Who is that girl? Did I say something to offend her? She did mention something about her memories.
Come to think of it, her memories did seem a little muddled. Maybe she was on the verge of getting them back.
What kind of memory would make her go nuts and run away like that? I'll wait here. Make sure you rescue her, okay?
So many invisible walls, one after another. Miss President can pass through them. I don't know if I can keep up the pursuit.
Kanji?
Is that you, Rise? The real one?
Thank goodness. I've been all alone since that weird fake Teddy captured me. And then you were all fighting each other.
Where are you now, Rise? Can you locate where I am?
I'm sorry, I don't think there's time. I'm stuck in the announcement room. Please, Senpai, you have to hurry! If you don't, he'll...
Rise! What's wrong, Rise?
Pardon me for interrupting while you are lost in thought.
Oh, I know who this is. Oh. Fudge, I can't remember her name, though. It's the robot from Persona 3.
I didn't mean to startle you.
You're...
It's nice to meet you. My name is Aegis.
There we are.
And no, I am not human. You are the one from the introduction video, listed as the sister complex kingpin of steel, Narukami-san. Correct?
Not Hanako is important to me, but calling it a complex is stretching things. Aiga-san, was it? Why are you here?
Our primary objective is the destruction of shadows, but we have come to this world on a different mission.
The destruction of shadows? And does that mean...
Yes. I have a persona as well. Though my body is a machine, personas are the strength of the heart, after all.
What is this mission of yours?
Aha! So that's where you got to, Sensei! I've been looking all over for you! Ooh, who's the honey? Were you in the middle of trying to score with her?
As if you didn't know. You're the one who lured us both here.
Did you figure it out? I didn't have a choice after those guys decided on their own to horn in on the fun. You're a bright boy, Sensei. You know what's coming next, don't you?
Sorry about this. Do you know the rule of this tournament?
Only the victor of each match may move on. Yes?
I have nothing against you, but I'm in a hurry for my own reasons.
Neither of us, in other words, can back down. Then there should be no hard feelings. That will not do. We will speak more of this after one of us wins.
Here goes. There's no need to hold back.
Indeed. Let us do battle.
Time's it? Okay. Argus!
Quick shot, Athena! Air strike!
match for you. Serves you right. Keep suffering. Friend against friend, beating the heck out of each other.
I don't know why you're making us fight, but it's pointless. We aren't fighting because we hate each other. The reason we can fight is because we respect and trust each other.
Stupid! You're such a dumbass! What's with you?
What are you talking about? Why did you set this tournament up?
Pardon my eccentric entrance.
What?
Please excuse me. I didn't have the faintest idea that someone would be here.
Faintest?
Fain? Fiend? Something along those lines at any rate.
Are you from the Velvet Room?
Is this what's known as being hit on? A forbidden ritual where one human approaches another based solely on appearance and bets on the inner self being equally attractive.
The fuck?
What? No, I'm not hitting on you. You just remind me of someone I know. Do you happen to know anyone by the name of Margaret?
Margaret?
Oh, actually, we should introduce ourselves first. I'm Yu Narukami.
Ah, oh, that had slipped my mind also. My name is Elizabeth. Dear me, to hear that name fraught with memories in such a mundane, remote place. Margaret is indeed my sister's name. Can I take that to mean that you are another guest of that room?
Elizabeth-san, huh? Well, I guess that's the case. It's true that there was a time when I visited that room. Why is a resident of the Velvet Room here? Did Margaret send you with a message or something?
I am currently utterly neglecting my duties.
Is that so?
I have a certain desire. It may take a very long time for it to be realized. In order for my wish to be granted, I require a power much greater than what I have. The power of the wild card that changes bonds into strength. I have a feeling that the key lies there.
I know a little about the wild card, but...
I feel that the first glue to granting my wish lies within that power.
Glue?
Flu? Influenza. Something along those lines, at any rate. Might I suggest that you and I fight? How excited this is making me! My expectations are ascending skyward at mock speed. To be direct, I'd like for you to show me the potential slumbering within you.
Let me make sure of something, just in case. You understand what I'm saying, right? There's no illusions at work?
Such parlor tricks can get stuffed!
I see. So you're actually in your right mind here. That's kind of, impressive. Won't be able to hold back.
Let us do this. Your fate is in the cards.
Okay, after this fight, I'll probably end the stream and then get ready for bed. Can you stop the combo? Combo? Oh, that was close. That was really close.